Good afternoon to all. Today our class is about chemical reactions from our 7th chapter, 9th class. What is myself, B. Rajender, School Assistant Physical Science, JPHS, Muthankal. We are observing different changes in our surroundings. Morning, sun rising, and sun setting, midnight, this way. And other differences also we are observing. The plant will be grow. Different changes we observing. If you put ice cream in that sunshine, it will be melting. So, some reactions, some changes will be temporarily. Some reactions will be permanently. Which are temporarily, that are known as physical changes. Only change in the state or color. Some changes are permanently. New products will be formed. That never be come back. Means if you burn a wood, then the new product will be forms as ash, but that ash never be changed reversely as wood. This type of permanent changes known as chemical reactions, chemical changes. Now let us be discussing about that chemical reactions. In chemical reactions, atoms are neither created nor destroyed. This is stated by that great scientist we learn in that first class, lead nitrate and potassium iodide reaction. The mass before the chemical reaction is equivalent to the after reaction. So he stated that atoms are matter neither created nor destroyed. Law of conservation of mass. So in chemical reaction, all chemical reactions follows this law only. So in chemical reactions, atoms are neither created nor destroyed. A chemical reaction is a process that is usually characterized by a chemical change in which the starting material known as reactants are different from the products. Chemical reactions occur with the formation and breaking of chemical bonds. Some common reactions, types of reactions we will be discussed in this chapter. First, types of chemical reaction. First one is that chemical combination. Chemical combination means two or more atoms or molecules will be combined with chemical change and forms new product, that is known as combination of two or more and forms one product newly, that is known as chemical combination reaction. For example, you take a magnesium ribbon. In 8th class you have to done this activity. In metals and non-metals chapter, you burn that magnesium ribbon. After burning the magnesium ribbon, the lightening is coming, heat is coming. After that, you will be get new product as magnesium oxide ash. So magnesium plus oxygen, both are reactants before the chemical reaction. These two combined and forms magnesium oxide. The new product is magnesium oxide. So that's why the combination of two or more elements or atoms or molecules and gives new product, that is known as chemical combination. For example, you take a coal and burn with oxygen, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide will become. The combination of carbon and oxygen, you get that new product as carbon dioxide. These are all chemical combinations. Now take a small piece about 3 cm long of magnesium ribbon and burn it. You will get that magnesium oxide. This is the our experiment. You will also notice release of enormous amount of heat energy when a magnesium is burnt into a burning of coal. When coal is burnt in oxygen, carbon dioxide is produced. Carbon plus oxygen gives rise to carbon dioxide plus heat, as well as calcium oxide. Calcium oxide plus water mix, you will get calcium hydroxide. This is also combination. Magnesium burns in oxygen by producing dazzling white flame and changes into white powder. The white powder is magnesium oxide. Mg plus O2 gives rise to MgO. In this reaction, magnesium and oxygen combine to form a new substance, magnesium oxide. Magnesium and oxygen both are before the chemical reaction, these two known as reactants. Reactants combine and forms that new product, that is magnesium oxide. Left side for chemical reaction, the left side we write reactants, right side we write products. A reaction in which single product is formed from two or more reactants is known as chemical combination reaction. A reaction in which a single product is formed from two or more reactants is known as chemical combination reaction. Here, calcium oxide and water, if you mix in a glass jar, after that you will get calcium hydroxide. When you touch this glass tumbler with your hand, you feel some heat. Means in some reactions here, heat will be evolves. That is known as exothermic reactions. Exothermic reaction. Therm means heat. Exo means evolves. Exothermic reaction. Magnesium burns, heat evolves. Coal burns with oxygen, heat evolves. And calcium oxide or sulfur lime added to that water, it is also gives that heat. Acid and base you will be combined, then you will get that heat. In which reaction heat is evolves, that is known as exothermic reactions. A solution of sulfur lime produced in the reaction is used to whitewash the walls. Calcium hydroxide reacts slowly with the carbon dioxide in the air and forms that calcium carbonate. Decomposition. Now we are observing decomposition, means divide. For example, you take a limestone. Limestone burns with more coal, then it will be divides as calcium oxide and releases carbon dioxide. Means the calcium carbonate is divided as calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. One reactant or one substance divided into two or more substances means products will become two or more. This is known as decomposition. For example, if you take water and electrolysis that water molecule, the water molecule divides to has hydrogen and oxygen gases. Means the water molecule decomposes as hydrogen and oxygen. Some substances will be divided into two or more substances. Reactant is one, product will be two or more. This type of reactions we know as decomposition reactions. Take a pinch of calcium carbonate, CaCO3, in a boiling tube and heat it. After some time, you will get that some gas evolves. That is, which gas? We don't know. So that's why you you put a burning matchstick near to that gas, the burning matchstick will be put off the flame. Which gas is put off the flame? Carbon dioxide. So from this reaction, we will be notice that carbon dioxide is evolves. So when you take calcium carbonate in a test tube and heat it up, then it will be divides as calcium oxide, that is remains in the test tube, bottom of the test tube, and evolves the carbon dioxide gas. That carbon dioxide gas will be put off the lightning matchstick. Another test is also there. If the gas is sent to lime water, it will be turns into milky white. So then only you will be noticed that is the carbon dioxide. In this way, calcium carbonate will be decomposed as calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. This is the picture from our textbook. Calcium carbonate unheated, then it will divides into calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. It is the thermal decomposition reaction. In this reaction, heat is observed. And another one is now we observing. Take about 0.5 grams of lead nitrate, PbNO3 taken twice. 0.5 grams of lead nitrate you take in a test tube and gives heat to that, and it will be divided, means decomposed as lead oxide and oxygen and nitrogen dioxide. One substance, one reactant divides and gives three products, that is lead oxide, oxygen and nitrogen dioxide. Here lead nitrate heated, you will be observed that brown fumes, brown color fumes. Fumes means smokes, pogalu, brown fumes. That are brown fumes indicated that nitrogen dioxide. PbNO3 taken twice, lead nitrate unheated up, it will be decomposed as lead oxide plus nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide color is brown. Brown fumes formed means nitrogen dioxide form plus oxygen. This is the one kind of decomposition reaction. Another one you have to see here. Take a plastic mug and put two holes in that one. From the two holes, put two screws which are conducting of the electricity, and two wires you will be attached to that nails. On that nails you put two test tubes, and these two wires connected with 9-volt battery. This is the arrangement. Now you pour some water, pure water, in that mug off of the above, and give connection to that battery. The electricity will be flows through the wires, and it will be electrolysis process. And then the water molecule H2O divides as hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. This is the one kind of decomposition by using the electrolysis process. For this, we will be add some salt or dilute sulfuric acid or HCl, anyone. So in this reaction, we first take a plastic mug and drill two holes and arrange two test tube on that, and two graphite electrodes attached to this holes and connected with wires to that 9 voltage battery, and fill the mug with water off of the above, and after that we will be add some sulfuric acid and gives that connection to the battery. Then the electricity will process through the water, and it will be divided as hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. If you compare that volumes also, hydrogen gas having two times more than oxygen volume. So hydrogen volume is two times more than oxygen volume. The hydrogen gas and oxygen gas is products when the water molecule decomposed. The water molecule is decomposed by the electrolysis process and gives that hydrogen and oxygen gas. Here the reaction is 2H2O. On the electrolysis process, we will get 2H2 plus O2. This is also one kind of decomposition. And also take some quantity of silver bromide. Silver bromide color you have to note down, first of all. And this substance put in that sunshine or sunlight. After some time, some color will be changed. You notice that the second color also. Then you will notice that a chemical reaction is occurs. So silver bromide is a yellowish color, and when you put in that sunlight, the chemical reaction is formed and it turns into the blackish color or grayish color. Means silver bromide is decomposed due to the sunlight, sun heat. Then you will get that silver and bromide dividedly. So that's why the color will be changed as gray color. Silver bromide, yellowish color, this is the reactant. When you put in that sunlight, observing the heat from the sunlight and decomposes as silver and bromide, this is the chemical decomposition reaction. Another one is there, silver chloride, that is also divided as silver and chloride. There are four types of main chemical reactions are there. One is chemical combination or synthesis. Two or more atoms or molecules combined and forms one single molecule, single product. That is chemical combination reaction or synthesis. Second one is that one reactant decomposed and forms two or more products. That is known as decomposition. And another one is single displacement. Another one is double displacement. We will be discuss later these two reactions in the next class. What is the reaction? Two elements or compounds combined to create one compound. The product of the combination reactions can be predicted by what reactants or compounds are in the reactant. Reaction. Combination reaction means two or more molecules will be combined and form single. Here calcium plus sulfur, both are combined and forms calcium sulfate. This is the combination reaction. And also hydrogen plus oxygen combines and forms the water molecule. A combination reaction is a reaction where two or more elements or compounds combine to form a single compound. Such reactions are presented by equations that as x plus y gives rise to xy. X and y both are reactants. Xy is product. Decomposition. Here, it is opposite to synthesis. One compound or one substance decomposed and gives two or more products. AB is the one product, AB is the substance and decomposes as A and B. This is known as decomposition. Here, water molecule decomposed and gives water molecule decomposed and gives hydrogen gas and oxygen, as well as hydrogen oxide gives hydrogen and oxygen. In this way, one product gives two or more reactants. This is known as chemical decomposition reaction. This is our lesson today. Okay.